Now, how to execute the queries? Once the database server is connected, either through this or we are having, this is basically called window platform, where we write down our queries and we get the result. Here again we are having a desktop version of accessing the MySQL database that we can get from here. You can see MySQL bin. So this is my MySQL installation in XAMPP. Here is a folder called MySQL. In that you will get folder bin. In that folder bin you will get this MySQL. So this is the command line where we can have our MySQL statements execute. For example, I can do here show databases. Here you can see there are two databases right now, information schema and test. So this is command line of my MySQL database. So we basically rarely use command line. The command line is used mostly on you can say admin system by administrators, not by a PHP programmer. A PHP programmer normally has MySQL bench or SQLio, where there is bit easy and more readable to understand the database and go through your data, everything which you can do with this SQLio or any other client. There are a lot of other clients that you can download and you can do your job. You can write down your queries like this. For example, here is a test database. In test database I'm having a table test1. So in test1 here is the table test1. Here you can see the columns and indexes. It is having two columns right now, ID column and value column. And ID, here you can see a key being printed in front of ID. So it simply means this ID is a primary key of this table. And value is another field or column in this table. So indexes, here in primary you can see primary in braces it is ID. So this ID is the primary key of this table. So this way the tables are displayed in our system. Here if we give, we are having a query that is called show databases, that displays databases installed on our local, on our server, MySQL server. I will do show databases. So when I will execute it, you can see this number of databases I'm having right now, and this list is also being displayed here. The same list is being displayed on the left side. So here, like, I have written a query show databases, and when I write show databases, I'm able to see the database list that I am having right now on my local system, on my MySQL server. It can be your local system or it can be remote system, remote server. That depends upon your application. So see, the same thing I've shown you, I have done show databases, and here is the list of databases installed on this MySQL server. So here are some of the installation steps. Basically, if you have a MySQL server and you have to connect to a particular MySQL server, I've shown you that screen, connection screen. So this is a window interface, a kind of battery interface where we can give our local host username and password. But if you are using command prompt like this and you have to connect to MySQL server, you don't have this kind of interface, then this is the command that we basically use. We give MySQL, then -u, -u, then we give the username, then -p, then we give the password. So when you press enter after that, like this, we will give. Here it is already MySQL server. What I will do, it is already on MySQL server, so I cannot do it here, but I will let you know the command. It will be like that, MySQL, then -u, -u, then username, then -p, and I think password is test. So if I press enter here, I will be able to connect to my database. So this simple thing I can do with the interface of SQLio. Here, I will simply give my host, I will give my username and password. So it will be here, I have just have to press the connect and it will open this window. Means it will be connected to MySQL server. So this is the command prompt way to connect to your MySQL server. So once you have done this, you have entered your username password. If you do show databases, you will be able to see the list of databases on your MySQL server. So this is basically how we can run MySQL at boot time. So this is very rare thing that we use. This is how we run and how we shut down our MySQL server. So connecting, I have shown you how to connect. So here is a simple command. We write MySQL admin and we give username and hyphen u username hyphen p password, then and we write the command shutdown. So our MySQL server will be disconnected. This simple thing we can do here simply by clicking on this cross. So it will be closed. So this is how we connect and disconnect to our MySQL server. Here you can see the command prompt database that I've shown you, this thing. This is the command prompt of MySQL server. So here you can see what I'm doing. To add a new user to MySQL, just add a new entity user table in the database MySQL. So this I will let you know through a practical example that how to insert a new row into a table, how to run a query to insert or to update a row or to delete a row, that I will let you know through examples. This is basically the command prompt that I have already shown you. Now setting up MySQL account. By default, when you install MySQL on your system, you get a default user, that is root. That is a default user provided by MySQL server, root without any password. But you can create more users with password that you basically want to have. So those accounts can access your MySQL database as per the privileges assigned to them. I will let you know what are privileges. Privileges simply means the authority to perform some action on a database, like not every user is allowed to delete a row, not every user is allowed to update a row, not every user is allowed to add a row to the database. So that permissions or privileges are up to the database administrator that assigns them. So privileges is basically authority kind of stuff that is allowed on a database by a database administrator to various users. So in order to refresh our privileges means privileges provided to a particular user or on particular tables like that, we can flush them, means we simply reboot or refresh our privileges while we start MySQL. So here you can write flush privileges. So it will do nothing, but it will flush your privileges. This simply means it will reboot your privileges. If there is something in between, that will be washed and it will flush everything. It will reboot your privileges. So here are different kind of privileges that are allowed to various users, like select privileges, insert privileges, update privileges, delete privileges, create privileges and drop privileges. Means privilege simply means which users are allowed to perform all these actions, or there might be some users that is only allowed to select something, select the records from a particular row. He is not allowed to insert or delete something. So this way various kind of privileges can be set by a MySQL administrator. again, we are having more privileges like references privileges, shutdown privileges, which user can shut down the system or provide the reference, who can run the process or who can stop a particular process, how the file privileged in databases, how we can reload our privileges in database. So to reload privileges, we are having a separate command. So which users are allowed to reload, run that reload command, who can create the index or update the index, alter privileges are there, grant privileges. For example, if we are, there is a term code in database replication. So if we are replicating some database, so in that case we have to grant privileges. So how we grant privileges, so all these kind of privileges are there in database. So simply I will let you know, we are having a command grant, and I want, for example, my username is root, and I want to assign him all the rights, all privileges. What I will do, grant all to root at the rate localhost. So this way, so here root is the username and localhost is the host. If I run it, so here I can see that this will provide grant to a particular user. So this way, not only all we can do, for example, I want to assign only select rights to a user, I will use select. If I only want to insert, I'll allow insert privileges to my root, I will do insert, grant insert to that particular user. If I want to give drop to that user to run the drop command or drop query, I will grant him the permission for that. So this is the grant command or grant query that is used to access any kind of authority or privilege to a particular user. Operating system level user is a different thing and database level user is a different thing. It might be possible that on your local system, on your Windows system, you are an admin, but it is not the case that you will be the admin on MySQL database as well. That are the separate permissions that are assigned by database administrators. For example, if you are running your application on a shared server, so in that case the database administrator is having the authority to assign various rights to various users, assign various privileges to various users. So this is the way we assign some authority or some right to a particular user. For example, I will write grant update, only update I will do, on, for example, my database name is test dot, here I'm having the option that I want to assign update query, update privilege to a particular user on a single table or all the tables of a particular database. So I can give like this, test 1 to root is my username, at the rate localhost. So this way what I'm doing to this root, that is the username of a user, I'm simply giving update authority or update privilege on only test one table of test database. Understood? If I want to give it the grant or the authority to access any table, I will do simply star. Test dot star simply means that this root user is having authority to update data on any of the table of test database. So here you can see we are having privileges like reference, shutdown, process. Now process is basically is that on a server, lot of processes run in the background that basically do our job. Whatever we are doing on server, in order to do that particular thing, a lot of processes are run on the background. So we can see those processes. I will simply write show process list, and when I run it, here I can see my processes. Here, see, username, then host, then database name, then what command goes on, it runs a query. Means in the first process, the database runs a query and it shows the process list. In the next process, the MySQL has executed the stuff and it sleeps. So this is the basic process list that we can see. So this is the process privilege that again we can provide or we can assign using the grant command as I have already shown you. So these are the basic privileges, basic kind of privileges. Like we can have reload privilege, we want to flush our privileges, or we have some file privileges like data in file or out file. This kind of stuff we can do with these privileges. So this is the MySQL configuration file. Let me show you on my local system. So this is my SQL configuration file on my local system. So here are various settings you can see. For example, which port is, this is the MySQL D, means default MySQL settings that I'm having on my local system, on my MySQL server. It is using port number 3306 by default. It is using this socket. Base directory is this. This is the temporary directory where the temporary data related to MySQL server is stored. Then this is the data directory where the databases are created. Like data. Here you can see I'm having databases, CDCOL, information schema, MySQL, performance schema, phpMyAdmin test, web auth. So here you can see the list. In MySQL folder, there is a folder called data. In data, I'm having all the data on the all the databases, and these are basically tables for my databases. Here you can see various table data stored on my MySQL server. So this table data can be displayed on a tool like this in a structured manner. So here are some of the settings: data directory, socket, user, base directory. If we are running the MySQL in safe mode, then where the error log will be stored. So these are the basic settings of my configuration file. Basically, in PHP there is phpini and in MySQL there is my.cnf. CNF simply means configuration file. So these are basic configurations that I'm having on my system.